FlexRay Protocol is a unique time-triggered protocol that provides options for deterministic data that arrives in predefined time frame down to microseconds, as well as CAN-like dynamic event trigger data to handle a large variety of. We have seen CAN and CAN-FD protocol in last couple of videos. After watching those sessions, do you see any problem in CAN protocol? Is there something in the protocol that could lead to a problem? Do you see some issue that could occur in arbitration approach of CAN? What if the priority issue, which has the lowest identifier, always sends some message? Not usually the case, but what if it keeps hold of the bus always, considering the principal advantage it has over the bus because of arbitration? How do we work with this kind of issue? We do have a protocol that makes sure that every ECU in the network always gets a say in the network. That's FlexRay protocol. FlexRay is deterministic, fault tolerant, and high-speed communication developed in association with automotive manufacturers and leading suppliers. So why FlexRay? With a lot of functionalities and features added to improve safety, performance, comfort of the passenger, there was an increase in the need of data to be sent faster and in a more reliable way. This continuous need of improvement of the network gave birth to FlexRay to meet the new challenge in the next generation vehicles. Let's understand the basics of FlexRay communication. FlexRay uses unshielded twisted pair cable to connect nodes together. FlexRay supports single and dual channel configurations, which consist of one or two pairs of wires respectively. Differential signaling on each pair of wire reduces the effect of external noise on the network without expensive shielding. FlexRay nodes can also typically have power and ground wires available to power transceivers and microcontrollers. FlexRay buses require termination at the end in the form of resistor connected between the pair of signal wires. Termination is only required for end nodes on a multi-drop bus. Typical FlexRay networks have a cabling impedance between 80 to 100 ohms, and the end nodes are terminated to match this impedance. FlexRay supports simple multi-drop passive connection as well as active star connection for more complex networks. Let's understand multi-drop passive connection and active star connection in detail. Multi-drop bus topology contains a single network cable that connects multiple ECUs together. This is quite common topology used in CAN and LIN networks as well. Each ECU in the network can branch up to a small distance from the core trunk of the bus. Ends of the network have termination resistance installed that eliminates problem with signal reflections. In star network, individual nodes connect to a central active node. This node is functionally similar to a hub found in PC Ethernet networks. If one of the branch of the star is cut or shorted, the other legs continue functioning. We also have hybrid network where bus and star topologies are combined. Future FlexRay networks will likely consist of hybrid network to take advantage of ease of use and cost advantage of bus topology, while applying the performance and reliability of star networks where needed in a vehicle. Let's compare few aspects of FlexRay and CAN. CAN is scalable, event-driven, while FlexRay is time-driven, deterministic, redundant, fault-tolerant, global time-based. Let's look into media access control. CAN is multi-master CSMACR, while FlexRay is multi-master hybrid TDMA. Looking into nodes, CAN supports 4 to 20 depending on the distance or topology. FlexRay supports around the same 4 to 22 depending on distance or topology. Bus speed, CAN supports 33 kbps to 500 kbps, typically 1 Mbps capability. FlexRay supports 2.5 to 10 Mbps. Looking into wires, CAN has a twisted pair wire while FlexRay can support 1 to 2 twisted pair wires. With respect to data and frame size, CAN supports 0 to 8 bytes payload while FlexRay supports 0 to 254 bytes payload. With respect to industry acceptance, CAN started in 1990s and is widely accepted since then in all regions. FlexRay has limited deployment in North America and wide acceptance in Europe. Considering cost, CAN is less costly compared to FlexRay. So let's look into the FlexRay protocol now. FlexRay protocol is a unique time-triggered protocol that provides options for deterministic data that arrives in predefined time frame down to microseconds, as well as CAN-like dynamic event trigger data to handle a large variety of frames. FlexRay accomplishes this hybrid of core static frames and dynamic frame with a preset communication cycles that provides a predefined space for static and dynamic data. FlexRay manages multi-nodes communication with a time division multiplex access or TDMA scheme. Every FlexRay node is synchronized to the same clock and each node waits for its turn to write on the bus. Because the timing is consistent in TDMA scheme, FlexRay is able to guarantee determinism or the consistency of data delivery to nodes on the network. FlexRay communication cycle is a fundamental element of the medium access scheme within FlexRay. The duration of the cycle is fixed when the network is designed, but it typically is around 1 to 5 milliseconds. There are four main parts to the communication cycle. A static segment. This is the reserved slot for deterministic data that arrives at a fixed period. Dynamic segment. The dynamic segment behaves in a fashion similar to CAN and is used for a wide variety of event-based data that does not require determinism. Symbol window. Symbol window is used for network maintenance and signaling for starting the network. Network idle time. Network idle time is used to maintain synchronization between the node clocks. So with this, we have looked into the main aspects of FlexRay. In the upcoming session, we'll go a bit deeper into different types of segments and see how these are synchronized in the network.